Hi and welcome. In this video, we'll learn how to connect Webflow with Mailchimp. So, as a setup, I have a demo page in my Webflow project, and I have two forms, a newsletter form and a contact form. So, I'm going to show you two ways of connecting this. One using native Webflow and Mailchimp, and one for the contact form using the Make automation platform. So let's first tackle this newsletter form. I'm going to my Mailchimp, and here inside my audience tab, I'm going to sign up forms. And here I'm going to the embedded forms. So you can customize it however you need. You can add other fields. I'm just going to leave it with the email address, and you can also add tags. In my case, I've added a newsletter form tag just to see that it works. Now, once you're done, you can click on continue and it will generate this code. So you can take this code and create a new element and paste it, save it, publish the website, and once it's done, I'm going to refresh my page here, and this pretty much works. You can enter an email address. It will submit to your Webflow audience. So let's see if it works. I'm going here, all contacts, and let's just enter an email address. So hello. PXMstudio.com. Okay, and click subscribe, and it worked. Now, if I refresh here, I'll see that indeed it added this email address. So I'm going to remove it for now, unsubscribe. And if you want to customize it, this is not. I'm going to cut it. So I'm going to delete this embed, and let's do it the Webflow native way. So to do it with Webflow, what we need to do is go back to our sign up forms and to the embedded form and click continue. And before copying this code, we'll actually take just a few parts from it, so we're not going to copy it entirely. So from here, we are going to copy this. We're going to copy from this form tag this part that is in action inside of quotes. We're going to copy it, and I'm going to go back to my Webflow, and inside this form block, I'm going to paste it here in my action input. So once I've pasted that, what you'll also need to take care of, if you have other inputs, is that you're going to need to look for the input. In my case, I have the email, and then copy the name. So copy the exact name, and you can paste it here. So for example, if you have, let's say I do have another input for the first name, like this, and this, if this would be my first name, let's click on the clock here. Okay, type plain. This should be type email. And let's go back and edit it a bit. So form fields, I'm going to add a first name. And as you can see now, we also have another input for the first name, and they call it fname. So I'm going to copy this fname, and inside my input, I'm going to paste it. So fname. But in my case, I'm going just to use the email address. Okay, so once we did this thing, I'm going to publish the website. just to double check. So we have the action, and then for the input, we have the correct name. So I've published the website. Let's refresh the page and make sure that you insert a valid email address. So I'm going to insert it on johndoe@gmail.com. So I'm going to submit this. And if I go back to my MailChimp account and go to all contacts, and we should see, there it is. We have a new contact here, the johndoe@gmail.com. Okay, so we have the mail address here. And this worked, and it's amazing. So the next approach, if we have a contact form, MailChimp actually has something for the contact forms. So you can go to sign up forms, and you can either use Make here, or Zapier, or Parabola, or other automation platform, or another approach, but it's less customizable, would be to use the contact form from here. So you can click on the contact form, create one, and it will give you a link which you can use as an iframe on your website. So just to show you iframe, and I can have an SRC here with 100% height, I don't know, 100 RAM, something like that. If I save and close and scroll, I guess RAMs don't really work here. So we're going to use pixels, and as you can see, we have embedded this native MailChimp contact form. But this may not be what you want exactly. So another approach, we are going to use a native Webflow form. I've created a simple form with first name, last name, email, message, subscribe to our newsletter checkbox, and privacy policy checkbox, which I spelled wrong here. So it's policy. Okay. So let's do it this way. I'm going to my make. I'm going to create a new scenario, and we'll need to search for Webflow. Watch events, and we'll need to select a Webflow account. So you click add, you can click add, and if you don't already have a connection, you can click add again to add a new Webflow connection. So I'm going to click save here, give it a name, and then it will open up a new window where we can select the website that we want, and then we can click on authorize. Okay, and select this, and as a trigger type, we'll need the form submission. And here, let's give it Webflow demo site too. Okay. And click OK. Awesome. So now we have one module, but the problem is that it's not going to detect all of the appropriate fields. So once we have added the Webflow module here, click Run, go back to your site, refresh, find that form that you need. I will enter some data here. So johndoe@gmail.com. This is John Doe, and check all of your checkboxes and click submit. And now, as you can see, you make detected our data and fields properly. So next step, we will add the Mailchimp module. Okay. And in this case, as you can see, it has a lot of options. I'm just going to add a subscriber. So I'm going to add it this way. I've already added my Mailchimp account. If you don't have a connection, you just need to click on add and then authorize with your Mailchimp account. And then you will need to select a list. I'm going to select this demo list here. And then you can just bind the data from the Webflow to Mailchimp. So for the first name, I'm going to use this F name. For last name, this L name. Birthday, I don't have. Email address is this one. And that's the only thing that we really care about. Status, subscribed, you can add tags if you want. I'm not going to do it in this case, and hit OK. But what we have there, this would work, but what we have here is that we actually have this checkbox, so only if they tick this box, they are subscribed. So I'm going to add another thing here. I'm going to add a filter and I'm going to select this and only if it's equal to true is going to work. Okay, so go to general functions here and select true and continue only if newsletter is true. Okay, and let's test it. Let's see if it works. So I'm going to hit run once, go back to my demo website and let's see, John Doe, John Doe 3 or whatever, gmail.com. This is John Doe 3. Subscribe and also take the GDPR and let's see if this worked. So I'm going to all contacts and we should see. Yeah, John Doe 3 is here. So let's see. So this seem to work and it also passed through here. So let's check if it works when the newsletter is false. John Doe 4 at gmail.com. This is John Doe 4. I will only agree to the privacy policy and submit. And now, as you can see, it didn't pass the check and we shouldn't have the John Doe 4 in our database and we don't have it. So that passed. And if we go back to the project settings to forms, we also have the form data here. Okay, so this was it. If you have any questions about Webflow, Mailchimp, or the Webflow Mailchimp integration, you can drop it in the comments section below, and we'll see each other in the next video. Bye-bye.